Good afternoon. This is Graham Updegrove. I'm your Central Coast real estate broker, and today I wanted to talk about why to hold assets and especially real estate in a trust and not in your name as an individual. So I typically talk to homeowners that own property. If they hold it in their names, try and go over some of the benefits of holding that property in a trust. Now, what is a trust? A trust is an entity whose purpose it is to hold assets or hold title to assets, I should say. And a trust can hold assets, it could be a checking account, a retirement account, it can certainly be real estate. And there are a couple requirements to a trust agreement. There's really three parties to a trust agreement. The first is the trustor. And when you hear that, think about the person that is creating the trust, that is putting property into the trust. The second party is the trustee. Now that's who essentially administers the trust. They would be shown on public record and they control the trust assets. And the last entity is the beneficiary. They're really the rightful owner of the property and they have the beneficial interests of that property, even though they may not be named as the owner on record. So here's a perfect example. I own my property in trusts, and if you looked up the public record, it would show Graham Updegrove, trustee of the 123 Main Street property. So on public record, I'm shown as the trustee, whereas one of these properties I own with a partner, 50-50 partner. Now, so we have 50-50 beneficial interests. Now, I'm shown as the trustee on title, and we were both the trustors because we created this trust. So what are the advantages of a trust? Why is it useful? One thing is privacy. You know, a trust agreement is not a recorded document. It's not something that you go out and show other people this trust agreement. So much like your bank account balance or your stock holdings, you know, that's not private information. But it seems like anyone with an internet connection can go out and find real estate that you own. So part of that is privacy. And also kind of to a certain extent, lawsuit avoidance. If you are named as a beneficiary of a trust, your name won't be attached to that property, whereas the trustee's name will. Another good example, Walt Disney World in Florida, how Walt Disney put together all of this land to create Walt Disney World without arousing suspicion of folks around that area and trying to hold out and get top dollar, is he created trust agreements and he would have an attorney act as a trustee, where Walt Disney was the beneficiary, and once he had accumulated all of this land, then he had his area for Walt Disney World. So that's the main thing. There is privacy. Another big reason to create a trust agreement is to avoid probate. Probate is not something that is typically fun. Probate really means proving a will. So when someone dies with an asset that doesn't have a automatic succession, you have to go to probate. It's a probate court. You have to provide public information or information that does become public as far as who is the executor of the estate, what the assets of the estate are, and really how that is going to get disseminated. If there is a will, that becomes public record. There's been instances of very rich and famous people who have died either with or without a will, but with property that's held in a way that doesn't pass on to their heirs automatically. And then, you know, it's for everyone that wants to view those records that can see them. So, probate is a costly and expensive and time-consuming process that if you take the time now, if you own real estate, to put that property into a trust now, you're going to avoid probate down the road. I typically suggest putting property into a trust really at any time that you own substantial assets. And especially, you know, if you have heirs, you know, for a couple that has a child, if you have heirs and you want any assets to pass on to your heirs at end of life, without having to go through probate, this is one of the important reasons to put that property into a trust. Now, for investments, there's a handful of other reasons to put property into a trust. One reason is a beneficial interest in a trust is personal property. It's not real property. So you can easily transfer that. You know, my beneficial interest in a property could be bought out relatively easy without having to go record something down at the recorder's office. Also, if there's multiple owners, let's say I own a property with four other owners, if we agree to sell the property, it's really only the trustee that needs to sign paperwork on our behalf. Now, there's the trustee holds a fiduciary responsibility that's kind of governed by probate code, but they need to act in the beneficiary's best interest. Let's see, last thing, when and then going back to avoiding lawsuits. I mean, anytime you have unscrupulous people that are looking to gain a quick buck, they're going to look for people that have assets. So if they can go down to the recorder's office and see that you own five different properties, you're at higher risk of lawsuits. Now, most married couples are going to own property in a trust. They're going to be the trustor, the trustee, and the beneficiaries. But going back to that Walt Disney example, if I bought a property and I had an attorney listed as the trustee, there would really be no way for you to find out that I had any interest in that property. So it's a great way to avoid litigation and, you know, dealing in California, it's a litigious state. Any way you can manage your risks to a certain extent is helpful. So those are some of the advantages of owning real estate in a trust. Now, what's the typical cost? Generally, $2,000, $2,500, somewhere in that range. An attorney should be able to help you put together a living trust that might include your real estate holdings, your checking account, any personal property, your retirement accounts. And then that's essentially an umbrella that helps all of those assets pass to your heirs at end of life. So hopefully that is a little glimpse into what a trust is. I know it can sound complicated, but once you understand how a trust works and the laws around it, it really becomes a lot more, it becomes a lot easier to understand. And hopefully that piques your interest. Hopefully you'll do some more research. You know, let me know if you have any questions. Just a disclaimer, this is not legal advice. Go talk to your attorney. And stay tuned for the next Facebook Live. I'll bring some new information to you that's hopefully helpful. All right, have a good rest of your afternoon. Take care.